parts about being
this
a man.
This is how good we are at MasterChefing. You can't even get your apron on. Turn around. It's just a bloke thing.
Like you can't tie knots behind your back.
Yeah.
There we go.
Try wearing a bra.
Okay.
MasterChef favourite, Manola De Silva. Is that good?
Yeah, that's good.
She's been cooking up a storm in the famous MasterChef kitchen, and this Sunday, the fans and favourites are going head-to-head in the Jaffle Challenge.
Did you know that the Jaffle was actually invented in Bondi?
Was it?
It was, in Australia, in 1949.
Wow, things you learn.
Font of knowledge. Now, Manoli joins us now live from Darwin. Good morning to you. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
We're just sensational. We've got smells coming up here, wafting up, that are just absolutely amazing. Now, the Jaffle Challenge is on Sunday night. You have the ultimate dessert Jaffle recipe for us this morning, and we're going to be cooking along with you here. So tell us what we're making. How do we start? What do we do?
All right. So we are making the most decadent Jaffle I've ever made in my whole life, and it is a take on a Snickers. So I've got banana, peanut butter, Nutella, and then it's deep fried with ice cream on top.
I've just checked.
I've just checked.
The Jaffle iron here is on. It's very hot. Can confirm. All right, so let's get into this. I can't wait. I love a sweet Jaffle. Stop laughing at me. It's a little bit burning. So where do we start, Manoli? Where do we start with making this gorgeous Jaffle?
All right, look, I'm going to go basic today. I've got white bread. It's so good. I just... You know, get some white bread, get some butter on it, turn it over,
and then let's get our toppings on.
Well, you know what? Yeah, let's do it. Butter both sides.
You want the butter over there, darling.
Yeah, well, you want to have both sides of the toast crispy, don't you? You don't want, like, a raw Jaffle on one side.
No.
There we go. Get into that and, plenty of butter on there. I mean, if you're going to do it, you might as well do it properly. Hey,
I thought you meant butter...
On both sides, like on all four sides.
Now, that's a lot of butter.
Oh, okay. Well, we're just going to roll with it because we can.
That's what we're doing now.
Okay. All right, butter
what fillings
is on.
Have you got?
Perfect. Yeah, so butter and then get Nutella. Look, I could eat Nutella straight out of the jar, but today we are going quite decadent.
Yes.
Okay.
So I've got butter... Butter on bread,
yes.
Nutella, peanut butter. Let's get some bananas onto there.
Do the bananas have to be really ripe?
Right.
Okay.
Look, I prefer a banana with some spots like that.
Okay.
Because then if it's got spots, you just know that there's flavour there.
Okay, so do you have to, with the banana, you just chuck it on or do you squish it on?
Look, dollop it on. If it goes... outside of the Jaffle, then you're doing the right thing. You've filled it enough.
Okay, cool. Okay,
there we go. And I've got it in. That's it. It's literally.
There we go. Oh, the wrong way. Sorry.
We've got butter all over the place.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, now what do we do?
What's next?
What's next? And then you take it out.
Yep.
You've got a Jaffle that looks like this.
Okay.
You dip it in flour.
Here we go.
And then egg wash.
You got one in
there. Panko crumbs, deep fry.
Okay, Do you really want to touch that?
Yeah, I'm not going to touch it again. That's a tip for young people. You want to use that.
That's what those things are for.
I'm not
for,
to be so trusted with the hot...
Finger to touch hot things.
Yeah, yeah, that was very, very silly.
It's a very clever invention,
like when you accidentally grab something out of the oven without
it. Do you want a hand with that?
A little bit.
All right, there we go.
Okay, we got it.
Okay, so we chuck that in flour. Yeah, or egg first. No, flour.
Yep, flour and then some egg wash.
A little bit of egg wash in there. Okay, wow, this really... Ow. It's probably not the healthiest thing that you've ever eaten, is it?
Decadent is definitely the word for it.
Okay, there we go. Right,
yeah.
Now where are we at?
You probably wouldn't want to be having this all the time.
Are these breadcrumbs
And then dip it in panko crumbs?
Panko crumbs, ooh.
A bit of panko.
Yeah,
these are great on prawns, aren't they?
Yeah.
It's going sweet today, though. And then straight in the pan.
So we're going to cook these up now, are we?
And then straight in... a pan with oil.
Uh-huh.
A pan with oil?
Well, let's just
Oh man, that's a heart attack on a plate right there.
It's
with
so
extra butter
decadent.
As well.
Wait, this is extra butter. It's not for the faint-hearted.
How would you serve this, Manoli? What would you pair it with? Maybe some ice cream just to, you know, amp up the sugar.
Sliced bread. Yeah, ice cream.
Oh, yes.
Of course.
How good's that? And how long will I have to cook for just to get those panko
you've got
crumbs
hot,
really
cold, yes. crunchy, smooth, salty, because you sprinkle a little bit of salt on at the end anyway.
So when you have this, do you have it for breakfast,
so it's
lunch,
just
dinner,
all the
dessert,
textures, all the flavours.
Like, where would you eat this? Because it will be your last meal, so what time of day would you eat?
Maybe at brunch.
Okay. That's not a bad
dessert?
Idea.
Yeah, bottomless brunch.
Maybe you have a salad for dinner and then you have this as, you know, the dessert.
All right, well, we've got a couple here, Manoli. We might give it a
no
taste.
Rules. You know what? No rules.
Don't miss the Jaffel Challenge on Sunday night on MasterChef. It's all happening on the Fans and Favourites Sunday night at 7:30 p.m. on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. 3, 2, 1,
right,
have a
go.
Here we go. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow. That's got, like...
That is...
sweet.
It's rich.
Crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
Rich.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much exactly what you're after in life.
We'll take whatever we can get. Manoli, this is delicious.
Mm.
Thank you so much.
I know you're heavily inspired by your mum.
Oh, you're welcome.
With your cooking. Now, your mum basically says it doesn't matter what you put in it, you've got to trust your taste buds. Isn't mm-hmm. that her theory?
You just got to trust that flavour will trump in the end. So, yeah, don't compromise on flavour. That's
we
what my mum would always say.